So, hello everybody. Let's see, Advent of Code Day 21. Man, it's 5 days till Christmas. I should probably do something about some Christmas gifts. Okay, so what is the today's challenge? Fractal art. Bring the pixels, convert each square. Right. 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 I think I understand. Okay, today will be fun, I think. So, we have array of booleans. And the answer has to be how many pixels stay on after 5. Okay. Let's see. Let's do integer and grid. I'm sorry. So, let's see. We start with this, and we have these rules. Okay, so we do not start with grid, but with list of rules. And after 2 iterations, there are 20. I can't speak to them today. So, 2, and the list of rules should be. How to do it? So let's see. We have. False, false, true, no, false, true. So this is it's really easy to get confused by this. True, true, false, true, false, 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 false. So this is one rule. False, false, true. True, true, true. And it changes into false, false, true. False, 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 and again. And then true, false, false, true, right? Let's just break it down. Let L format do its magic or not. What? So where did I go wrong? Is closed. This is closed. This is closed. This is closed, and this is also closed. Okay, so the problem is somewhere else. Yeah, right. Okay. So okay, we have this rule. So grid. List of right, so these are not arrays. From list. Parse, right. So starting grid is false, false, true. True. So input has to be split by lines. Parse rule. Wait. I have added the number there, so we have to do it a little bit differently. So oops. So we have to split by the arrow. So input, output, otherwise input, and if we do this, then parse grid right. So string split by slash, and then list map parse row. Parse row is false and this is true, otherwise let's see. Okay, so air, right? this is what's wrong. Okay. Okay, so parsing is done, and now for the computation. So starting grid, run. Grid, and it gives me, in the end, it gives me an integer. If iterations left, then what count those pixels that are on? So grid. So count through grid. Filter. No. Array map. To list. List sum. And now row will be array filter filter, I guess, identity. Right, okay, this works. Now else, so what about the rotating and flipping? Okay, so so let me Let's see, I have to. I have to sketch this down. So so if I do, so this is 0 clockwise. Once again and once again, and now flip. Okay, so this is already there. I think. No, right, it's not. So I just did something like this. We'll see. So we have to have all 8 of those. I think those are unique. And then so these rotations, and then right, we'll see. So rotation. Is there anything like transpose? There's not. Okay, so maybe let's use lists. See, does this type check? Doesn't, it should. Great, list of bulls. Right, set to list. But this should work. Why doesn't it? Set from list. List of comparables. So is list not comparable? Return values. List of grid. Grid is list of booleans. I probably don't see what's wrong. If I do this, does it change anything? Successfully compiled. So I guess it doesn't like lists. I get grid. This is list of grids. I don't get it. I don't get it. So let's do it sometime else. Transpose. But it doesn't do what I want, right? It will do. Yeah, it does both. Flip and rotate in advance. 1 4 7 2 5 8 3 6 9. So it does flip. And then it does rotate. Okay, so so what we want to do is transpose, then flip. So flip, it is just did I try to do? Well, it doesn't matter, right? It doesn't matter whether I flip horizontally or vertically. So rotations are done. So we have to take groups. Divisible by 2 means that create list length, okay. List length of grid is even. Rules. So we should probably change this into two lists of rules. Should use, I guess, something like partition. False, okay. So right, this should change into So this works again. So, list extra, and now we have to divide it into these. So it'll be groups of two or three, right? Group size. Okay, we have the groups. Let's just see. Right, there's just one group. Do this. Right. Great. So, now all rotations. So we have those in a list. Now for each of those we have to transform it and then we have to put it back together. So list of small grids. List map rotations. Now, does it always have to match? So they don't say what happens if no rule matches. So I guess we can crash if it doesn't. We'll see. So list of grid. So rules. Rules for free. Groups after matching. Okay, and then we have to connect them. But wait. Let's do it. We'll have to do a little bit. We have to do something different. Because this only takes. we want to do. Base. Okay, let's back up a little. Okay, let's do it like this, and we need to get it into. Two. Into these grids. AB 3 4 CD ZY 5 6 and XY 7 8. So I wonder whether I should do like by index. How should I do this? So this grid is a list of rows. Oops. Hello, Asblom. So I wonder whether I should do so it's grid. Oops. Well, no, I do not want the permutations. Yeah, the spelling. So, basically, this. This is what I'm struggling with. So it's length divided by. Group size, so we will get like 2. And now Now we can get the indexes. So I need something like 0, 0, zero and zero two and two two. So let's see. Cartesian product. I need to add by some number, right? So, or no, I can just do number of groups. Yeah, is numbers, so this list map. Oh, come on. Times. Group size. So, this gives us 0, 1, and this gives us 0, 2, and Cartesian product. Should give us zero, 2. No, I'm not. not sure when I started. Like, I use macros, but not for anyone, of course. Other people do this. So, I should probably use and then. Oops, I don't want a bookmark. Am I crazy? And then. And then so this will be quite ugly, I think, after I'll format it, but I don't care. So we should get again 0, 0, 0, 2, 2, 0, 2, 2. Now indexes. So list of great. Wow. So let's see. Let's take length. Group size. Group size, and now on make group. Okay, so let's just do. I wonder whether I should keep the structure, like in rows and columns, or just keep it simple. Not really sure. List of grids. No, I think we will be able to somehow connect them using the information we have here. So let's keep it at list of grids. So right, and we need the index. Start at X and Y. So drop X, take group size, and then do the same thing, right? Y. Actually, no, this is why. So, match rules does list of grid into grid. Takes rules. So now I just have to find the first one that matches. Right. Filter map. Match rule. Should I go this way or the other way around? Grid rotations or rules? So one of the rules has to match. So case rules of empty list, neural match, something. Else so if it matches, then new grid. So if it matches what? Grid matches rule. So grid rotations, list filter. Oops. Grid matches rule. List is empty. Grid matching rule. And this, else this. So we can do of empty list is this, and grid is rule grid so so can I, so the rule is just, where is it? From a grid to a grid. So output for the rule is the same in all four cases. Okay, so I don't have to transform the output back. So use rule is like this, right? Okay, so if list empty grids matching rule, then this else this. Oh, grid matches rule. So it is just equals, right? That should be enough. So, where am I? Here. So, I think we have the groups. Let's just see. Well, there's not gonna be many of these. Rotated groups, false to false. I'm not sure what to look at. True, true, true. Okay, it seems it does its job. Groups after matching. So there are four groups, and wait, there is one group. That makes sense because we started with one. So what happens? So we get it in like A, B, C, D. So we have to split. We have to get groups of what? Number of groups in row. So we do. Wait, what did we start with? Started with grid. So we have to do another run of this. Rules stay the same and new grid. So GH So I wonder, it can be divisible by otherwise. Okay, so if it's divisible by 2, then we don't do this. Okay. So right now I'm just doing a sketch of how my data looks like and what do I need to do with it, like visually. So will show you in a little while. I go thing down here. So this is the original grid. We split it into this. I hope we did it right, but it is, the code is written. And now I have to take a list of these and somehow connect them together. So it seems I have to split them into groups and then take each row of these and connect the rows. So groups after matching extra groups of what? Groups of number of groups in a row. So this does IM. Right, so they are lining up, and then list map. Each group row, and then something. So here I have to take the I have to connect the rows. So how to do it? So fault. I have to take let's see. So I have to create one, two, three, A, B, C, four, five, six, D, E, F, alphabet. So I think I can only use default. So fault. Wait, fault one does something weird, right? So let's use not normal fault. Fault now. So I'll these are both grades, and row, left row, right row, and we'll just do this. I hope so. Okay, and here we got this. Now we have to concat. So let's do concat map. No grid. Wait, what? That was not right at all. Hey, my cat is a dick today. So, grid output is why? Row of grids is this. Why would it lose? So one of left and right should be right. And the output is output of what? Oh, right. So, blah, 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 blah. Repeat this how many times? Group size, right? Maybe, probably. Output of a band. There's nothing. Maybe that will do. Seems right. So, match rules, case rules of narrow matched. So, there are like give me a second. I had to somehow specify the cat. So what does it mean? No rotation matched? The rules are the right size. So nothing starts with false true false. False, false, true, false. But this is the rules, right? Okay. Let's do some. Let's visualize it. So. List map. String from list. String join with a new line. And now visualize grid. Let's try it somewhere. Hyper, thank you. So, list map visualize. So groups, there is just one of them. It looks the same. Just get rid of some of the output. Groups after matching. Okay, let's try. Let's do it like this. Visualize string. Right. So run. Indexes, groups after matching. Starts with groups. Okay, groups after matching, right? So this is probably not a grid, but let's try it anyway. And new grid output. And let's do. So, run starts with this, okay. Groups, right, left is nothing, right is this, after append, okay, we have a problem. So, there should be, it should not be group size. but this test passed. Impossible. Okay, so I want to believe. Get your puzzle input. 5 and this. And this. I hope. So, should it be 5? 5 iterations. One for one. This is not the right answer. Okay, so let's back up a little. Let's see the test again. So it ended on the same, right? Okay, so this seems to have worked. Okay, so what to do? I think I'll just have to like see the output and see what's wrong. Oh no, oh no, oh no. This is not right. Anyway, slightly better. So, we start with this. Groups after matching. Okay, so can I? I only have to match one of the rules, right? I think. So I only have to match one rule. So we can see. is nice that there is some regularity in the input. Okay, so let's resize it a bit. And now let's find so, okay, I did not find it, so it must have found a rotation. Okay, so let's maybe try to say the match rule. So input output. So let string equals something. Yeah. Right. I certainly hope so. So, grid list map each row string join row and string join by a slash. And now visualizer. What? Did I remove stuff? Compressed list. Grid of list of list of. Okay, so it's. Yeah, sure. List character, this is list of strings, string from list. Right, so let's run it. So this is the match rule, right? So we start from here. So right, this makes sense. I can see there. Now starts with this, so we have these groups. Right, makes sense. Makes sense, makes sense, makes sense. So group after matching right, and right. So I wonder whether I am putting them back in the wrong order. Let's do it by hand. So we get this. Okay, so and now the roof, so the empty one was on the top left. It changed into nothing, three. So does it match if we do new grid output? It kinda does. So let's check the other ones. So three of these should change into 0 0 1 1 1 1 1 0 0. And what do we see? So yeah, we see this is wrong because this should be here on the top right. So what we can do, let's just try to find it. Groups after matching. So we can't get. Visualize row after append. So I would expect. Wait. Yeah, here. So I would expect row after append. B. So this is definitely wrong. So let's see. Right now I am just guessing like where should the transposition be, but no real idea. So, but this is what I thought it should be, so let's see what the answer is. 125. Hooray, that's the right answer. Rank 383. Wow, this is really hard puzzle. Whoa, so we got one star. How many pixels stay on after 18 iterations? So is this just a matter of like I don't know. Like it grows so big it starts being so slow? I'm not sure. So after thank you. So run with 5 and then yeah right, so compute one, let me copy this, run with 18. So I'm really interested in like whether yeah whether I make it. Okay, so we have to change the input a bit because it's not part of the in like the puzzle anymore. Input. String. String lines. Okay, so yeah, right. So this iterations are not there anymore. And compute two. So maybe I should stop. I should probably stop. Printing out. No, we are still printing out. Whoa. Iterations left. Come on, come on. You can do it. You can do this. Yeah, this is painful. This will take a few minutes. So, while we are waiting, let me just see how my colleagues did. So I am the first one. Okay. This one is painful. If this is today's puzzle, I don't want to know what is tomorrow's. So right now I am just like passing time. I don't want to optimize this. I will just wait. I hope I don't run out of memory. It seems okay. Okay, one more iteration. There was one visualization I wanted to see. I hope I don't crash my computation in the other process. Wow, that looks cool. Let's run it again. Yeah, sorry, I overlaid the chat, but wow, that's so cool. And by doing the like springing motion, it can probably do a lot of these like collisions and like, edge cases. Wow. Somebody believes in me. I don't know enough Polish to answer, but I do know enough Polish to understand. So, yeah. Okay. Let's clean up this. Man, I really hope it doesn't crash. So when did this person write this to me? 35 minutes ago. So might it be in... No. Like, is it you? Probably not, right? I want to believe. So if the final grid is then what was the length of the grid before? So whoa. So either line is Yeah, so, right, so 1458 was the one before. Makes sense. So what? So what's 9 times? Not really. Can't get to the right answer, but never mind. So, how do we look? The memory is still kind of looks the same. Okay, I want to see the monitor. I want to see the screen. He doesn't care. Never does. But he's awesome. Can you see him? I hope you do. So, PEF Q, how long did it take for you? Like, did you write it in like imperative language or like with one that doesn't have like immutable data types? Was it fast even at 18 iterations? Can't really see him. Come on, turn around. So 5 seconds. Wow. Nice. So I am probably doing some very bad optimizations or lack of optimizations. What? So, this is really uneventful part of the programming challenge, but it is kind of therapeutic. You created a dictionary with all of the rules. Rotated and reflected. Yeah, so I am rotating at the real lookup time. So that might be one thing. So I don't know whether I should. I probably could. I do have enough memory. I can try to spin up another version of this that tries to do that. And we'll see if it finishes faster. Yeah. So. Oop. Regen old blocks in primitive style, right? Well, it's not ugly, like for some problem, or in some programming areas, like this is the way to go. Like, Haskell-like style isn't the answer to everything. Let's see. Sometimes I have to get into Rust. It seems like this is the like it's both imperative, but it has some nice like take some stuff from function style, so I think it is still like from what I've seen it seems to still be on the imperative style side mainly, but it would be nice to see like what the next kind of C looks like. So let's see rotation. So basically, parse the rules. So we should match them up. And this is a list. So let's do a set. Set of rules and it should be. Does the dictionary make sense? From input to output, probably does. And so we can have only one of these, right? Dictionary from grid to grid. So rules. Rotations. Parse rule from grid to grid, and then input output. Let's do rotation output. And then we can dictionary from list. Dictionary dictionary from list. That should be it. Now, rule. Rules. Match rules. So we don't have to do rotations. Match rules, okay. Pa, ha. Right. I think this can stay the same. Match rules. So, dictionary from grid to grid. Grid. So let's choose. Yeah, so yeah, makes sense. Case rules of nothing. So this will essentially, I think, become a one, right? So of if it's nothing, the debug crash and output output. So this might be it. I'm not sure. Watch or run 2017. Rule. Compute. Rotated rules. Dictionary from list. Grid A, grid A. What? Oh man, okay. I have to use different dictionary. Stick section. Oop. No. So in the end, this crashed. So I'm glad I started rewriting this. So what happens? Let's see. So So line 60. From list, it should work. So what's wrong here? Concat map, right? So it seems a bit faster. Still kind of run slow, but it should maybe be at least like until like it should finish before the heat death of the universe, and hopefully not crash. So the memory consumption seems lower. Like I applaud like Eric for the like, you know, the inputs are just right, so that like you can't just do brute force and be done with it. Like you have to optimize a bit, at least like I do. Like if somebody writes it in C, they probably can get a bit like they can manage a bit higher inputs. But like this 18 iterations, it seems just right. Like 19 would have been like undoable. Yeah. So please work. Did they? Here. Wow. 10 minutes for both. Yeah, so they just, right. They just changed the 5 to 18 and waited 15 seconds. Wow. So 6 plus 9 there. 15 seconds. Crazy. So we know it was fast. Like the runtime of that. Wow. One other person in the Elm community did it already. Whoa. So please be right. Yeah, that's the right answer. Wow. So took me half an hour to do the part two. Wow. So thanks for the optimization tip. Like use the right data structures and don't recompute stuff, right? So yeah, this was intense. And we are done. So let's Let's finish this. Why is the dictionary there? Empty file, okay. Dictionary 217, remove 21 and yeah, thanks for being here. It helps me when somebody talks to me. Which is weird because when I started I thought like it will be you know, it will be interrupting me, but it seems to be fine. So great, we can put it here, push it, and yeah, that's the end. So thanks a lot and see you tomorrow.